So the first tip that I have for you today on Illustrator features is going to allow us to rotate this circle evenly spaced out at a specific amount of times. But you need to want to turn on the smart guides by pressing Command or Control U on your keyboard, and then hold down the Alt Option key and Shift, and then click and drag to make a circle perfectly in position. Now we can actually check that these are aligned by using the aligned function that Illustrator provides for us. Now say if I want to rotate this circle 20 times perfectly and evenly around this one, I can press R for the rotate tool and then drag the icon right down to the middle. Hold down the Alt Option key and then click again. Now if I don't know 20 times in degrees, I can just type in 360 divided by 20, and Illustrator is actually going to do the mathematics for us. Now that's really awesome. And then hit preview, and then hit copy, and then press Command or Control D to repeat the process. And like magic, we now have 20 different circles evenly spaced out around the original one. So next, I'm going to show you how to create color harmony with one easy function in Adobe Illustrator. So I can actually copy this design by holding down the Alt Option key and then clicking and dragging. Now if I want to add a completely different color scheme to this design, I can just come up to Window and then choose Color Guide. In this menu, we have an option called Color Harmony, which when we select one color, Illustrator is going to choose different colors that work in harmony with that first color. Now this is awesome, and it even supplies monochrome, so you can apply that to your designs really easily indeed. Now I'm just showing this as an example. Of course, the original design is actually fine as it is. But look how easy it is to apply different colors to your design that work in harmony. Just click a color and then apply it to the shape, or you can use the eyedropper tool too. Next, I'm going to show you how to save memory and also how to not slow down your computer when using the transparency effects. So here's my logo, and I'm going to add a grunge effect to it in the transparency window, and it's actually going to really slow down my computer. So let's go ahead and open up the transparency window, demonstrate what I'm talking about. So click your design, then head up to Make Mask, head into the right hand window, and then uncheck the clip box. You're going to put your effects into the right hand window. But first, deselect your design, and then copy the effect with Command or Control C. Head back to your design, select the right window, and then press Command or Control V to paste in the grunge effect. Now it's already slowing down my computer. But let's go ahead and add another effect by duplicating it for a second time with Control V. Now this has really slowed down my computer, as you can see when dragging the effect along the page. You always want to click the left box when you want to actually move around the design. And as you can see, when I drag it up to the top, my computer is really lagging and struggling. But yeah, it's transparent and the effect is through the logo. But so how can I actually improve the speed of my computer with this effect? What you need to do is you need to come up to Object and then Flatten Transparency. You absolutely need to make sure that you preserve the output transparency, which is going to allow you to have the effect work on your design. And of course, choose high resolution. Once it's finished flattening your design, I'm going to then move around the design, and it's not so laggy as before. Granted, it's still a bit laggy, but it's been improved a whole lot. So if you want to actually clean up your design using transparency window, make sure to flatten the transparency after you finish the artwork. So the fourth one is that when we want to select the polygon tool and create a shape that has multiple sides, we would normally just click it and then click the artboard. Then you can type in the sides that you want to use. So as you can see, I've created a hexagon. But instead of doing that, just take the polygon tool, click and drag on the canvas, and then you can press the up and down arrows on your keyboard to change the amount of sides that you're going to use. Now this is really useful, and it does help to save time when working in Adobe Illustrator. But it doesn't just work with the polygon tool, it also works with the star tool too. However, there is no quick way to adjust the size of the spikes on your star, but it can quickly change the amount of spikes on the star. And for some reason, this design on screen now is quite jarring on the eyes, so let's move on to the final point in today's video. And before I give you the final tip today, like and share my content on social media, and also subscribe if you want to keep boosting your skills as a graphic designer. But yeah, the final tip today is going to help you select all text and outline it in a matter of 2 seconds. So we can press Command or Control A to select everything, and then press Command or Control Shift and O on your keyboard, which will outline all of the text. Now this is especially useful for very text-heavy documents or designs. As you can see, my text is now vector shapes. But you should be aware that it's not always a good idea to outline your text, and you can actually turn your text into a compound shape, which would allow you to apply most effects that you wouldn't normally be able to do. That was today's video on 5 different functions and features in Adobe Illustrator. Let me know what you thought of today's video down in the comment section below, and of course, stay tuned all this week for more graphic design content. Have a great day, everybody, and until next time, design your future today. Peace.